The only real like epiphany moment I've had, it was too sort of weird to call an epiphany, I guess. I'll take you through it, right? It was when I decided that I couldn't carry on with the relationship I was currently in. It was only like a few weeks long, but we were in this park, right? And I saw the best thing I've ever seen in a park, all right? It was a tiny little furry cute dog. And there's no other word for it, rimming. A bigger dog. That itself was rimming an even bigger dog. Now, right, buckle up, this gets a lot better, all right? This was not like a circle jerk thing, it was a static stationary line, all right? Ascending, they were violating each other in height order. It was logical yet disgusting. Kind of how I imagine Croft to be like if it was German. This kind of weird, depraved order to the whole thing. From behind us, though, we then hear this. Sammy! Sammy! Has anyone seen? Sammy's my little... Oh, this little girl looking for a dog. And I'm like, oh, please, please, universe, can it be one of... Sure enough, she comes through and she's like, has anyone seen my... Because she is looking for the smallest dog, which is the one that's really going at it. Kind of... It looked like it was trying to get to the top dog by burrowing its way through the middle one. And the middle dog was a fucking horrible dog. Like, a really grim working class dog, you know. It had testicles. I think that's how you tell what class a dog is. I think it is. You think about it. If it has testicles, then it's working class. If it doesn't, it's middle class. If it has a jumper, then it's upper class. Ever see a dog with testicles and a jumper, then there has been a murder. Anyway, right, she's going, Mom! And then this proper posh lady, right, over by the pond, and she goes, Bernard! Right, then starts trying to pull the back end of the dog off the middle dog, but Bernard does not want to go home. Bernard's like, fuck you, lady, I'm a dog, this is what I do. Starts stretching his dong out, trying to hit the flower of Slumdog over here. Right, she's going, Bernard! Mom! I'm going, this is amazing. This is the best thing I've ever seen. This is a memory for me now. Like, I never fought in a war. I'm going to tell my grandkids about this. Like, this is insane. Isn't this amazing? And I go, Becky, isn't this incredible? And she goes, So I broke up with her there and then. Like, that was so... I'm sorry, it seems harsh, but I thought about it. You know what? I think you have to have an opinion about that. Like, you can either think that's amazing or disgusting, but you cannot be bored by it. Like, what have you seen? Have you seen, like, 5 dogs doing that? 10? Have you seen horses doing it with, like, a stallion all the way to a Shetland pony at the other end? Or, like, all the animals of the world with, like, an elephant all the way down to a shrew, really, a shrew. And then Evel Knievel goes, like, oh. You seem... I don't know.